you've never seen the show before, this is the segment we call Love is Nice. It is the counter-programming to what's on the NFL, all our fantasy football players out there who are in relationships with these loving, empowered, intelligent women who don't need no man, but went out and found you because and gave you, you know, I believe in you. They don't believe that your fantasy team is worth spending any time on, though. So you can't watch that. No, you're not allowed to watch that. We're going to watch this instead. And if you buy that, if you say, yes, yes, dear, yes, we will, I will, we won't watch, I can just watch it on my, I'll just watch the numbers on my phone. Because of this, I can't do it. Because of this, that's why we're going to watch this instead. We're going to watch whatever you want. You want to watch South Beach Love? Let's watch South Beach Love. I bet it's good. Or we're going to go over all you knobs out there who decide to go that route. Because she loves you. Here's what you're going to be watching. South Beach Love comes on at noon. You can't watch pregame. From New York Times bestselling author Carrie Pinion. Oh, these are all the same. I guarantee these are all the same. I did a quick search. I recognized. I didn't read through these, but I recognize. I got a good eye. This was last week. I saw this last week. This is the Quinceañeras. Yeah. And Hallmark Publishing comes a story about rival Quinceañeras. Why you got white people doing shit for Quinceañeras? They don't know nothing about no Quinceañeras. Glorious Cuban cooking, friendship, family ties, and romance. Stars William Levy and Taylor Cole. Couldn't pick wire names than that. To star in this movie about Quinceañeras. Get out of here. So it's insulting, too, if you think about it. But they don't care. Because at 2 o'clock, forget that. Forget Quinceañeras. But now we're going in the air. We're going to love it. Love takes flight. It's taking flight. In the Hallmark Hall of Fame. This is Hall of Fame shit right here. A young girl befriends a lonely widower as a part of her mission. Find a friend. Uniting their families in a healing twist of fate. What the hell? Who goes in? First off, a young girl befriend. First off, that chick doesn't look young. That if that's the one who started, that chick don't look young. She looks like she's in her late 20s, early 30s. Young to me is, you know, early 20s, mid 20s maybe. She looks like she's pushing it. And there's a kid involved. Why are you going after widowers? I don't understand that whole dynamic. Okay. Oh, really? You lost your wife? Well, let me come in here and spread my legs for you. See, if that makes you forget her a little bit. What? That's so fucked up. But I guess that's what women like nowadays. Fucking. And this is what you're going to watch. And if for some reason they're in a helicopter, what does this have to do with... What does that have to do with taking flight? Are one of these guys, are they going to fuck in a helicopter or something? Helicopter hand jobs. Gotta love it. Love, take two. Lily produces a wedding reality show, but her success-driven world, she's a success-driven world. It's success-driven. Is flipped when her ex, Scott, is cast as the groom-to-be. She has no say in this. Oh, who are we bringing on? Oh, that guy I used to fuck? Nah, he didn't make the cut. Sorry. Let's bring on Omar. Nah, he's better. I don't know him. Lily must revisit her past if she's to find her own happily ever after. Heather Hemmings and Cornelius McCornelius. What? This make you see these shows, like I say every week, they're never just regular people. They're always show producers, and this one's doing she's doing the lonely widower thing. What? And here's another one. These are writers. I saw this last week. When a love advice author and a dating columnist cross paths. Oh my god, they're crossing paths. Oh my god, sparks. Attraction blooms into more. It's gonna. Now, you know they're gonna. Why would you get involved? You know this guy writes about this stuff. Why would you get involved with somebody? Hey, let's read his article. I fucked this girl, and she made him the worst lay ever. That's the main title of the article. Hey, wait a minute. What? Why would you do that? Especially if you know the guy's going to write about it. Fuck out of here. Using strategies from their own playbooks. Is it possible they both bet their own match? I just want to read the fucking articles. And at 8 o'clock, Chesapeake Shores, that old feeling in your pants. Luke's court case is here, and Connor comes to the defense despite personal risks. Abby faces a romantic dilemma when... This isn't even the same show from last week. Abby faces a romantic dilemma when Evan declares his true feelings, and Jay wants more than a friendship. So two guys want to fuck her. That's like every show. I'm sure that's part of the dynamic every week on these shows. And at 9 o'clock, instead of watching, yeah, like the end of the first quarter of the game, you're watching Sweet Autumn. Aunt Dee, Spencer Candy Shop between her niece, Maggie, and Maple Farter, Dex. Following letters, Dee left, the two uncover the reasons for her decisions during the Sweet Autumn Festival, stars Nikki DeLoach and Adam Walker. Now, I would be totally pissed if my aunt, who, I mean, she must know you wanted this, but you're going to go... split it with this guy. She's like, how does she know this guy doesn't have like herpes 8? Nah, just go hang out with this guy. Maybe something will sparks. More sparks. They got sparks shooting at your thing because you got super AIDS. At 11 o'clock, you get Golden Girls. I'd rather watch Golden Girls. And that's the show. Good luck this weekend, guys. I'll see you next week at Friday, 6 o'clock.